I feel sorry for Winnipeg. They played a very good game. Anderson doesn't have much to do tonight, but he had 17 shots, I think, the first period. Kept them in the game. Got their arms started, Winnipeg, and they come back. But I have to ask you a few questions, all right?
Certainly.
First of all, what is the very first thing? What the referees, they used to, you know, just call penalties and stuff like that. Here they are, worried about a guy's visor, and he doesn't even have to. Now, what's this here? Tell me, why do they do that?
You're not allowed to have dark tape because it could be confused for the puck.
For the puck. And now watch this one. Tuck in the sweaters, and they did it with Marner. Now, the reason the guys tuck in the sweaters is when they're small. Marner was small. I remember when he was minor midget, and he was a bantam. He's small, so he tucked it in, like Dougie, like Gretzky. Anybody that's small, they tuck it in. First of all, what is this here? Give me what the stick again.
The stick was because the goalie's stick could go back in the net and it could be confused for the puck, a dark object. But that seems to be a bit prehistoric.
Well, then some of them have black tape.
Yeah. Can't have black. Got to have white.
Yeah, but I know. But on the blades, the guides of the whole deal, that is absolutely ridiculous. Somebody must think about this. Anyhow, and the other thing, too, the sweaters, why do they have to have them tucked in?
It's a dress code, and I don't know the answer to that.
Nobody knows the answer. Yeah. These guys sit. Let's do this. Let's do that. Anyhow, let's go.
Come on. Alley-oops. Winnipeg Jets, and there's one other for
We have to do this here. Lonnie puts this here over, and Eller's his friend. Look at that there. Beauty like that one. And this is the best there. Watch this here. Isn't that beautiful? Not only is he a goal scorer, he puts it like that, but the best one I think I've ever seen is this one coming up here, Carlson. Look at that. And the best, two of the guys that I was... not beautiful, the Forsberg at the end, nobody even talking about the goal. Andy, the best I ever saw, the two guys, Cornwallier used to take off, he wouldn't even look, and J.C. Trombley used to put it up. It's funny thing, that was 50s and 60s, the 70s kind of got away from it, and now they're back onto it again. I guess they watch Coach's Corner.
Jonathan Drouin, poor Montreal, is getting hammered tonight by Ovechkin and the Capitals, but he had a great start.
Well, in this game, Price had 45 shots. Now, this is like at the end of a practice, watch Drouin. I mean, it's like the end of a practice, like just easy like that. I'd like to ask you a question. You're a pretty smart guy. While this is going on, Eichel just signed a $10 million contract, right? And he got him to score goals, right? Mm-hmm. And he doesn't even get in the shootout. What do you think of that?
It was a funny one, for sure. But he looked good. He made a beautiful
pass. Anyhow, he should have been in the shootout. You've been 10. I always go the top guy. Oh, we should go first. Go ahead.
Big guns were really rolling early, Don. Just before we show Connor McDavid's now famous goal, Patrick Kane and the Blackhawks got 10 on Sidney Crosby's Penguins, and you had a theory about Chicago.
Oh, well, if you want to hear that, we used to go to the finals all the time or the semifinals, and it really took us time to get going after that, to get going. Now, Chicago, they're on a mission. Believe me like that. Pittsburgh, you know, I don't care what you say. When you win two in a row, you're not as hungry like that. And everybody picks everybody else, Dallas, and I like Dallas going to be the most improved. But Chicago, don't count out Chicago because they're on a mission. They were embarrassed last year by Nashville. Don't count them out, okay?
So T.J. Brody, was he embarrassed on this goal by Connor McDavid?
No, you're very good. And it was not Brody. It was Hammerlock. Now watch this here. He gets caught. It's not Brody's fault at all. And everybody made fun of him. He's up there. It's Hammerlock. He should have been in there and covered up, as we always talk about the hinge. Now, we're going to talk about now.
Here he is,
Hamernick. If he had been about, he would have caught him. But listen, let me tell you about David like this. This guy, now, who is this here? This is
Victor Mete.
Oh, Mete. See how he's covering up for him? Mete, I'll tell you a story about him. Played for junior Canadians. I went in the dressing room. The coach asked me to go in the dressing room. And I said, which one's Mete? He said, what is going on here? You're not skating. Get going. And here he is skating. He's the best skater I ever saw in minor midget hockey, including McDavid. He's the best, and he's up there now. I hope he wasn't on for too many goals tonight.
All right, we're getting a little tight, as you can imagine. Ben Bishop gets hurt last night. Vegas gets their first victory thanks to James Neal, but here's Bishop's injury.
Now watch how many times have I said, don't put your stick down. Oh, there he is again. You can hear these guys on TV. There he is again. Watch. Stick goes up, hits him in the head, and go down he goes. Keep your stick out of the way. And there he goes out of the game. They lost that game because he wasn't in there playing right now. Keep your stick out of the way. Guys, I can always tell when it hits the stick because the guy goes up like that.
Jake DeBrusque.
Listen, Jake DeBrusque gets his goal for Boston. And watch Louie and my buddy Louie, and the big tough guy, can take anybody on. He gets a tear in his eye. Nice goal. A little too much celebration. Louie, tell him to calm down. And there's Cindy right there. And he gets the goal. Now, watch him after. I love this big, tough guy. He gets. Imagine his son in Boston Garden scoring this goal. Tell him, not so much. They play cool. Anyhow, watch Louis here with Cindy, Julian, and daughter, and the big tough guy. And there he is there, boy, I'll tell you. Must be great to see your son score in the Boston Garden.
You and Tim are out scouting all the time. Last night I was at the Canucks game with Tarasone for, obviously, Rogers' hometown hockey's in Niagara. Frank Pietrangelo, his wife Kim, put on an unbelievable show with their Junior B Canucks.
Do you remember? Here he is here making a save. And I'll tell you the story. He makes a save. It was 3-2. If he doesn't make this game, it goes 4-3. It was on Stastny. He come back and won that. They won that game 4-3. And then he went in the seventh game. And he won the seventh game. And Tom Barrasso, you remember Tom Barrasso.
Yes, I do.
All of a sudden, he's not hurt anymore. And he never got back in a series. And you're going to see him tomorrow night.
He'll be on the air.
Yeah, he's a great guy. He loves it. And you got Derek Sanderson, Mr. Niagara Falls, and the whole deal of Hudzik and like that. Now, we have the Prince. Can we go show this? All right. Prince Albert Raiders right here. Mark Hobscheid. And they've got my jacket on. And it's like that there. It's for organ transplants. Don't these good guy looking, aren't they beautiful looking guys? I'll tell you like that. And they wear it, and the WHL is putting on, all the teams are putting on. Started with the Vancouver Giants. And I want to just show you, they picked up this beautiful, this is my vest. I didn't wear the thing like this, but anyhow, that's my vest. Anyhow, God love you. And it's Thanksgiving. Thank the Lord for all your blessings.
Thank you, Don. Almost makes you want to be out of your gourd. On the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada.